Assalamu alaikum. I am Afif Osman from Al-Bahria CSS Institute. Today we have with us Mr. Hassan Jahangir, who has qualified CSS in 2014 and have been allocated in Police Service of Pakistan. I leave it to sir to introduce himself further.
Assalamu alaikum ji, I am honored to have been invited here from the platform of Al-Bahria Institute to introduce myself and to interact with candidates. So my brief introduction is that I am from Police Service of Pakistan, CSS 43rd Common Training Program, which is actually CSS 2014 batch. So I'm here and I've qualified CSS all three times. My first attempt was CSS 2011. I was not allocated. I was 140th in that attempt all over Pakistan. And then in my second attempt, I got allocated to Police Service of Pakistan. I got 30th position in that. And I had also given my third attempt, CSS 2015 afterwards, and I qualified that as well. I scored 760 marks in the written portion of that exam, but I did not go for the Viva because I was already allocated to my first preference group, which is PSP.
Sir, we'll be heading towards the answer question sessions.
Sure.
Sir, most of the students are of the view that educational background matters a lot during CSS preparation. What is your point of view about it? And please tell us something about your educational background.
Okay, first of all, my educational background is that I'm a graduate of electrical engineering. I did my bachelor's from University of Central Punjab in 2010. As far as the educational background is concerned, for certain subjects, for example, if some person is a science student, he might be, you know, very much, you know, ahead of those students who did not have a science background in everyday science or certain other subjects which have, you know, scientific knowledge in them. But there are certain students who are good in social subjects, social sciences, and they have education in social sciences. So it's not like anybody is advantaged in this exam or anybody is lagging behind the others. Some people have, you know, grip over certain subjects and some other people have grip over other subjects because of their educational background, and that is the point of this exam, that we have diversity in it, and that is all that matters in the civil service, because we have people from all these diverse backgrounds and qualifications that really helps in public service delivery.
Sir, many students face failure in English and comprehension paper. How did you tackle these two subjects?
Well, the answer to this question elicits a very elaborate response, and it requires a lot of time to answer these questions. But the important thing is that most students do not have proper and strong foundations in the English language. If you see, these papers are totally, you know, they check your English expression, especially the essay type paper. And our students think that just because they can write in English, they can express well in English as well. These are different things. Writing in English is one thing, and being able to express your opinions in a very effective and elaborate manner and being able to communicate it to the other person as you intend it to be communicated is an entirely different thing, and that is where they lack, and that is what they need to work on.
Sir, many students face failure due to wrong choice of optional subjects. What was your strategy in choosing the optional subjects?
The important thing in selection of optional subjects, I, you know, repeat this again and again whenever anybody asks me this question, is that don't listen to other people, don't listen to your friends, don't listen to the academies even, I would even say that, and don't listen to any person, or even if your sibling is suggesting you that you should opt this subject, or even if, you know, like you have an educational qualification in that subject, it's not mandatory that you have to pick that subject. Just go through the CSS syllabus and decide for yourself that whether the subject is suitable for you or not. If it suits you, you can even turn the most difficult subjects into very scoring subjects. But don't listen to anyone. Go with your own hunch, go with your own inclinations, your tendencies, your aptitude. And that is how you can ace the optional subjects portion of this exam.
Sir, many students remain under high pressure while doing CSS preparation. How did you manage stress during your whole journey?
Well, if you talk about me, I am the kind of person who listens to music, who watches movies, who reads books. And, you know, you cannot study all the time. We are human beings, we are not machines. So stress, you know, piles up only because you take it very, very seriously and you take it on your head and you tell yourself that you have to, since this is a very difficult exam, you tell yourself that repeatedly and then you start, you know, stressing over it and that you have to study. You listen to your friends, they are studying for 16 hours and you, you know, make sense of it like as if you are lagging behind them. Every person is different. Every person has a different selection of subjects and you do not have to follow the other people. Just, you know, go with your hunch about that. And take time out for your entertainment, for your sleep, for your other family activities, and allocate a certain portion of the day towards the preparation of CSS, or you know, make your proper schedule and follow that. Don't listen to other people. Again, since I already said that in case of selection of optional subjects, I'll reiterate in this case also, don't listen to other people when they tell you that they have prepared this much or that much. Every person is different and you have to just focus on yourself.
Okay, sir, it's a big issue that most of the students qualify the written exams, but they are unable to cope with interview session. How was your interview experience?
Well, there are a lot of misconceptions about the interview portion of the CSS exam. Students become something, candidates become something they are not. They pretend to be somebody they are not. The CSS interviewers are very experienced. They can see and they can distinguish if you are not being yourself, if you're being natural, or if you're being fake. The important thing is that when you're going for the CSS interview, just have to be yourself and you have to have proper grip on your optional subjects as well as compulsory subjects, as well as on the issues of the present time, whatever that time is. And you have to have a firm grip over your you know, optional subjects especially, because it really you know, it's really bad if you are going for a CSS interview and you are unable to answer those questions. And you should have opinions, you have formulated opinions about various issues, and you should not be blank over there. When they ask you about opinion on certain issue, and if they are recruiting you for the most prestigious civil service exam, you ought to be good enough for that. And the only way you are going to be good enough for that is that since you are in competition and there's always somebody going to be better than you, when even if you have qualified the written part of the exam, you're still up against many hundreds of people, against a few hundred seats in CSS. Probably you're against 1,000 candidates. So always the you know, it is the survival of the fittest at that point. You have to put in maximum effort at that point to make sure that you qualify this part also, not just qualify, but get into the service of your choice.
Sir, why did you choose PSP, Police Service of Pakistan?
Well, I think that PSP, in my opinion, is the service that you through which you can effect and you can help and you can serve people from grassroots level to the elite. Everybody in Pakistan, everybody in the country, is, you know, you can help them through one way or the other. For example, if I was in the tax services, in IRS or customs, I would have only interacted with the rich people who are able to pay taxes. I would not have been able to serve the, you know, lower classes of the people. I think PSP and PASS are two services in which you're able to serve at the grassroots level and you are able to interact with the public. And that is a very, you know, emotionally and otherwise, it is a very fulfilling experience when an old man comes to your office and that old man says that aap mere mai baap dono hai. So an old man twice or thrice your age says that aap uske mai baap hai, there is nothing better than that.
Exactly.
And when you help that person and you see smile on their faces, that is the best feeling, and that is why I've joined the police service.
Good. Sir, what do you think, what is the role of academies in CSS preparation?
For those candidates who do not have any even basic idea of CSS, I say that they should seek guidance from any academy or any mentor or any CSS qualifier. It is absolutely necessary because they show you direction. But for the most part, you have to study yourself. They can only guide you as much as they can, but it is then up to you. You have to work on yourself, you have to hone your skills, and then you have to attempt these papers as well. So it is both a matter of control over your nerves. It is, you know, like academies can only guide you. They can show you the direction. The rest is up to you.
Okay, sir. Sir, any advice for CSS aspirants?
Well, the only advice that I would like to give them is that just be yourself during the preparation of these exams. Don't listen to people. There is a kahawat, there's a saying in Urdu that jitne muh utne mulaize. So if you listen to a lot of people, everybody is going to have their opinion about what subject you should select or how you should study, what should be your methodology. You should know yourself before you listen to other people. Follow your instinct. Follow your tendencies, your inclinations, your aptitude, and go for that. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.